It happened very subtly, but very quickly. We had a talent show one Friday evening. It felt like a scene in Les Mis. You know, we may not see each other the next day. And then just out of nowhere, we're isolating. Hey.
All right. Good to see you again.
All right. I think it's on.
When this crisis hit, it was no surprise that the entire community, this faculty, the staff, the students, and the alumni, all rolled up their sleeves and said, what can we do to make this better?
So this term is a teaching term unlike any other I've ever experienced.
My current work setup, very different to my office at the Blavatnik School, but it's working.
When you think about what makes this learning environment special, it's certainly not the room. It's the learning culture that matters.
The term started and I really hit the ground running.
You know, I'm digging deeper into the readings. I'm making sure that, like, before each class, I'm up to date with every development.
In terms of interacting with the teacher, nothing has changed.
So this is a Malaysian student. This is a Chinese student. This is an American student. This is our dean jumping in because I told her it was a fun discussion, so Nairi jumped in.
For the last decade, people have lazily thought that education is either in person or
it's online. And online means
large scale, fairly anonymous, you and the material, not you and your teachers. And what we're doing at the Blavatnik School is really carving out what it means to have virtual in-person teaching. That really puts you, the student, at the center of our attention.
You forget how integrated it is with very special talent and very special academics.
The professor for education policy, Tzioli Tamir, was the education minister in Israel.
Awesome!
Yeah.
Yesterday, I had the head of the Obama Foundation in a conversation with our students.
This morning, I'm taking a class in economic development with Paul Collier. He's one of the leading economists in the world.
What they do is bring the old regime down.
In terms of delivery, in terms of interactions, I think that it has been as close to pre-COVID times as possible.
You can say we are unlucky to go through this, but it's also lucky for us to be here with all the top minds around the world during this pandemic.
I would have looked at this pandemic with a different lens if I was not in the MPP.
The experience that you're getting here, no matter if it's online or physical, I mean, it's something that will change you forever.
I think in the next few years, what I will carry on is that statement from the Dean, Nairi Woods, that says, the best of leaders are not the people who know it all, but they are the people who know where to find that information.
They leave the year really bound to one another, knowing that every time they make a decision in their public lives, there's going to be 120 people standing behind them, ready to help.
I think we're going to need each other for the rest of our lives.
Having a family that you can always call your own.